The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, weighing in at 229 pounds, the world champion, Kenny Omega.
Plenty of action coming up as we have six of WWE's top names ready to go here.
Oh man, Michael, six-man matches like this always remind me of World Class back in the 1980s.
Byron, are you friends with Anderson and Gallows?
I'd like to consider myself on good terms with them.
Because they talk about you a lot.
Oh, yeah? What do they say?
They say, nerd!
And his partners, at a combined weight of 505 pounds, Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows.
You know what else they should probably say about me? They probably say that old Saxman guy, he's too sweet!
They literally have never said that, Byron. Bona fide legends in the land of the rising sun. Anderson and Gallows, two of my favorite people to be around outside of the ring, because inside, they're all business.
I'd like to hang out with Anderson and Gallows outside of the ring.
You would never be invited to Brother Softly with these two guys.
I'd like to have abs like Anderson.
Oh, yeah, me too.
From Boston, Massachusetts, weighing in at 220 pounds, Eddie Edwards.
Six-man tag team action coming up next, guys.
And both these teams come into this match incredibly confident. But unfortunately for one of them, they're gonna have their confidence crushed by the end of this one.
And his partners, at a combined weight of 420 pounds, the world, David Flynn Lee and Justice Robinson.
Guys, how do you think the champ looks heading into this match?
He looks a little relaxed to me. Maybe it's because the title's not on the line here. I don't know. Either way, I can tell you once the bell rings, he better be ready to go.
This should be interesting, guys, as six of WWE's top names square off here.
Sit back and enjoy, guys. It's not every day you get to see six big-time names like this in the same match.
And I can't help but wonder how the champ's game plan differs, if at all, knowing that the title is not on the line here tonight.
Looking to hurt him here. Oh, my God, shoulder breaker.
That could cause long-term damage.
Great height.
There are instances when a six-man tag match will feature a team where superstars have not always seen eye to eye, or are in the midst of a disagreement. When that's the case, someone on the team must step up and be the voice of reason so the trio can function as a cohesive unit.
tends to happen when members of a six-man team have differences or had differences in the past. If the team can't find a way to get on the same page, they will not last very long. Someone on the team has to step up and make sure for at least that match, everyone on the team can work together.
That's easier said than done. Just because superstars might be favorites of the WWE Universe or have a common enemy, that doesn't mean they'll get along. It also doesn't mean that any past issues will magically go away. In this business, people have long memories, so if someone sees an issue on their team, they need to resolve it right away.
Tag team offense on the way. Dropkick hits the mark.
Ooh. He's starting to show signs of fatigue, but he's not appearing too worse for wear. At least not yet, anyway.
It's hard to tell at this point, but perhaps the unpredictable nature of this match is too much for him to overcome.
By the looks of things, I don't think he expected his opponent to be as motivated as he clearly is here tonight.
In 2016, the New Day found themselves in the middle of a sick and twisted rivalry with the Wyatt family. Things escalated to the point where Bray Wyatt invited the New Day to do battle at the Wyatt family compound. New Day accepted, but what followed was something no one expected or will ever be able to forget.
What's coming next?
Corey, we've talked about six-man tag matches, and earlier you talked about one that caught the attention of the entire sports entertainment world. The New Day fought for survival amongst the darkness of the Wyatt family compound in a battle where pickaxes and cinder blocks were used as weapons and automobiles were used as battering rams.
The New Day versus the Wyatts at the Wyatt family compound was not your traditional six-man tag match, but it showed what can happen when issues between factions can't be resolved through a sanctioned WWE match. I'll tell you what, none of the men who fought in that conflict will ever be the same. Something that is always important in a six-man match is having the ability to perform double-team moves. One of the things that successful six-man teams try and execute are double-team moves and then have the third team member perform a signature or finishing maneuver to deliver maximum impact.
This could be over.
Teamwork is always paramount in a six-man tag match. Superstars want to be able to have a...
We know what this is. It's a stampede.
How much he has left.
Here he goes.
Shoulders on the mat.
Pin's broken up.
I can't believe it.
Slam down hard.
He's in full control now.
Big move coming.
Heartbreaker. But he's running on fumes here. Does he have enough left in him to capitalize?
There's no denying the impact of that move.
What's he gonna do with it?
He might have it. Jolly old whippersnapper.
This one's over, guys.
And he stops the count.
Lucky him.
Comes up big with the reversal.
Whoa, down he goes.
That was impressive, Cole.
Long way up in the electric chair.
Dropped from above. We may be looking at our winner here, guys. Hey, what goes up must come down.
This is not going to end well.
Look at this, the Ulster Plantation.
That's what the shoulders are down.
One, and the count's broken, keeping the match alive.
Luke Gallows in with the tag.
Big boot.
Luke Gallows starting to stall a bit here.
And you know, all three of the superstars he's up against can lay down at any point during this match.
When you put that much meat in the ring, somebody's going to get hurt. And unfortunately for him, he's the one on the receiving end of this inevitable beatdown.
This is it.
Oh, the stunner. That was the best one I've ever seen.
To think, I almost...
And he goes for the pin. Two. And he kicks out.
Still too fresh.
Gets the tag.
Over time, there have been various types of six-man teams that have been successful. There are family trios like the Guerreros, the Grahams, the Andersons, and the Von Erichs. There have been members of factions who have also produced tremendous six-man teams, like the Fabulous Freebirds, the Four Horsemen, the NWO, and D-Generation X.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
Oof. Byron, you mentioned some families and groups that created incredible six-man teams. Talking more about factions, don't forget about the likes of the Hart Foundation, Evolution, the Wyatt Family, the Shield, and the New Day. These are only some of the trios who had unbelievable matches against a variety of adversaries.
We're talking about three-man teams. I need to shout out one of the baddest trios of all time. Great job escaping, trying to turn this thing around.
Boy, he is rolling.
He's starting to stagger a bit. We all know, though, this guy has plenty of fight left in him.
You know, there's an art to being a successful tag team competitor. And right now, he resembles more of a finger paint.
He's doing exactly what he did want to do.
What's he gonna do now?
Time to flip it.
Boom, switch.
Game, set, match. This one is over.
He's going for the pin. He breaks the pin.
This might be it.
Oh, my.
Oh, man, what a hit.
Knocked right off the apron.
Uh-oh.
Scoop slam.
Setting up in the middle.
Elbow drop.
Six-man tag team matches have been a staple of competition since the early days of sports entertainment. Two teams of three compete against one another under traditional tag team rules. Stipulations can be added like no disqualification, two out of three falls, elimination, falls count anywhere, or whatever else someone could think of. Matches can also be held in a caged environment.
Six-man tags can be fought under so many different types of stipulations. Teams can be part of a faction, with three superstars of the line being of a common interest. The most crucial aspect to a six-man tag team being successful is that trio's ability to act as one cohesive unit, three individuals working collectively at all times.
So much can take place during a six-man tag match. Regardless of what type of match the teams of three are competing in, the members of that team must be on the same page. Oftentimes, the teams who have the best continuity are the most successful.
Showing some quickness there.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy.
That runs throughout Southeast Asia that Carl Anderson is responsible for. Now, Anderson has brought that to WWE, and whether it's in singles or tag team competition, no one is safe.
Carl Anderson with a nice reversal.
He's making a statement here with this attack. That'll do some serious damage.
Since Carl Anderson debuted in WWE, we've witnessed that this man is as vicious as they come. Just when you think Anderson's done beating on you, you realize the attack has only just begun.
Carl Anderson is a ruthless individual, and when he locks up with an opponent, he's not looking to just defeat you. Carl Anderson's looking to finish you off once and for all.
There it is. The tag has been made.
Oh, he needed that in the worst way, Michael.
When this guy's on, look out.
Goes down hard.
Flying forward. From the floor.
Oh, the reversal by Carl Anderson.
He's fighting back here.
I expected nothing less, Cole.
Carl Anderson with a nice reversal.
This is truly a test here to see what Carl Anderson can do. He has to come up with a plan quickly.
He may very well have reached the point of no return here in the six-man tag team match.
That's over at this point.
Yeah, no question. He's showing great energy as usual.
Looks to me like these superstars are running on fumes right about now.
Bringing it back between the ropes. Back in the ring again.
Nailed it.
And stomping away in the corner.
Just ruthless. Dodge that one.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business. His partner's looking to get back in this thing.
Caught his breath a bit, now he's ready to go again.
Whoa, Anderson dodged that one.
He hits him with a reversal.
Should be getting punched up right now.
Shaking spine buster from the good brother himself.
Here's his moment, Michael.
Uh-oh, this doesn't look good, Byron.
Yeah, this is how people end up getting hurt.
Boom!
It's that time.
A pin drop!
Looking for all the glory here.
Almost there.
So close.
And he tags his partner in.
Momentum has certainly shifted here, Michael.
Is it.
And with the cover.
What a comeback. This, that should do it right there.
Two,
three.
What a six-man tag match.
These guys were awesome. Let's take another look.
Man, oh man, look at that. He's getting after it here.
Yeah, he's putting in the work.
I really enjoyed every minute of this.
Here are your winners, Kenny Omega, Carl Anderson, and Luke Gallows.
Now that's eking out a win.
That is what I like to call a statement win, Michael.
The arena is still buzzing over that great match.